Hey guys, welcome back to another Best of Wall Street Bets video. Today, we're going to be looking at some of the top losses and gains from the past couple weeks. If you're new to the channel, we make videos covering insane Wall Street Bets traders and other topics related to the hottest stocks right now. So be sure to hit subscribe and hit the bell if you want to see more. To begin, we have the user XXLearJetMeeksXX posting a video of his Robinhood account, showing him going from $4,000 to $42,000 in May, thanks to the Zuck. Before Facebook's recent run-up, LearJetMeeks purchased June 12th out of the money calls. He continued his gains by going all in with June 16th calls, which he rolled over to July 17th as Facebook stock rose. By the time he cashed out on May 26th, his account value was $42,653, up over $38,000 from just the beginning of May. He believes there's still meat on the bone for Facebook and plans to eventually get back in for a run to $262. Congrats on your Facebook gains, LearJetMeeks! Next up, we have the user Tommy1010 posting a Robinhood screenshot showing his account up $65,248, 180%, in just the past month. Tommy1010 put 100% of his portfolio into DraftKings by purchasing numerous $30 and $35 calls, along with 1550 shares. Luckily for Tommy1010, DraftKings continued a massive run-up to over $43, with the stock price doubling in just the past month. Despite already being up over $65,000, he hasn't cashed out yet and is still holding all of his positions. Tommy1010 is a DraftKings diehard and believes the stock will continue to skyrocket past $50, so he is holding strong. He believes there's still a ton of room to grow, with sports coming back and everyone's still locked down, so he's putting every dollar he can get his hands onto into DraftKings calls. Congrats on your DraftKings gains, Tommy1010! Next up, we have the user Socialist Baby posting a Robinhood screenshot showing that he's down $62,058 on his Roku calls. Socialist Baby purchased 382 Roku call contracts expiring May 29th with a break-even price of $131.86. Unfortunately for Socialist Baby, Roku's stock continued to dip over the past month to around $110. He quickly learned the hard way that Roku makes you broke. However, he hasn't learned from his mistakes and plans to get his losses back by putting his remaining $70,000 into Roku January 29th, 2021 in the money calls. Best of luck with your Roku comeback, Socialist Baby! Next up, we have the user I Know The Codings posting a screenshot of his account showing off 4 years of gains of over $2 million. I Know The Codings began investing with $100,000 4 years ago, with large positions in Greatland Gold, Wabash National Corporation, AMD, and Norwegian Cruise Line during his time trading. Thanks to Wall Street Bets, he got the idea to purchase AMD stock, which he purchased for an average of $11.58 per share. His position in AMD is currently over 20,000 shares, and he also has a large position in Norwegian Cruise Line. Despite his massive 20x gains, I Know The Codings is still working a day job. While only in his mid-30s, he plans to hold Norwegian Cruise Line for a while until it makes a good recovery, then retire. His advice for traders is, limit the number of your positions. Don't chase revenge fear of missing out trade, and nearly every lesson you think you've learned will be the wrong lesson to apply at some point in the future. Congrats on your insane 4 years of gains, I Know The Codings! Next up, we have the user Sir Jackalot responding to I Know The Codings' gains, showing his account up 20x to $761,266 in just 3 months. Sir Jackalot started with $40,000 and wrote up Alpha Pro Tech, Slack Technologies, Co-Diagnostics, Norwegian Cruise Line, and Norwegian Cruise Line again with stock plays. He considers himself a momentum trader and tries to take advantage of dips, sensing fear of missing out, then getting out before the rug gets pulled. He is always all in with only one stock and prays that he gets lucky. This continues to hold true today as he is currently all in with 42,410 shares of Norwegian Cruise Line. He chose to go all in with Norwegian Cruise Line over other cruise lines because they have the smallest fleet to redeploy. He believes cruise lines are a safer bet than airlines right now because cruises have only one role, vacations, while airlines have business for all sorts of use cases. Users on Wall Street Bets agreed that he has gotten extremely lucky and encouraged him to diversify and protect his gains. However, he plans to ride Norwegian Cruise Line until he believes the ride is over, then get into GLD and eventually get into boring ETFs. Congratulations on your 20x gains and best of luck with Cruise Line Holdings, Sir Jackalot! Next up, we have the user Gord Snipes, posting a Robinhood screenshot showing he's lost over $38,000 on his Casper shares. Casper Sleep is an e-commerce company that sells mattresses and sleep products online and in retail locations. Gord Snipes saw a couple of their ads on Instagram and decided to pump in $52,000 during his workout one day. He invested the day after the company's IPO at $14, then eventually sold at $4. Unfortunately for Gord Snipes, he now regrets selling because Casper's stock has since rallied over $7 again. Despite buying high and selling low, Gord Snipes is remaining positive in life and doesn't believe money makes you happy. However, whenever he sees a Casper commercial, he still wants to break his TV. Best of luck with your future trades, Gord Snipes. Next up, we have the user Papa's New York, slow cooking his Penn tendies to perfection. Penn National Gaming operates 43 casino and racetrack facilities in the United States and Canada. They also own a 36% stake in Barstool Sports. On April 2nd, when Penn National Gaming stock dipped to $9, Papa's New York purchased 30 $40 call contracts expiring January 15, 2021. Luckily for him, Penn National Gaming stock has rallied during the past month, all the way up to over $30. This resulted in an insane 2,222% gain of $13,493 for Papa's New York. Despite some users on Wall Street bets advising him to sell now, he apparently plans to hold his calls for another 5 months while his tendies cook. Congrats on your Penn gains, Papa's New York! Next up, we have the user Your Everyday Joe, posting a Robinhood screenshot showing gains of over $11,000 on his BJ's Wholesale Club calls. Your Everyday Joe purchased 100 BJ's call contracts, expiring June 19th, with a break-even price of $40.47. Luckily for Your Everyday Joe, BJ's stock surged over 20% after the company reported profits and sales well above expectations. After these impressive tendies, Your Everyday Joe decided it's time to try another earnings play. About a week later, he posted a screenshot showing that he's up $15,000 with his Zscaler Inc. calls. Your Everyday Joe purchased 100 Zscaler call contracts, expiring June 5th, with a break-even price of $100.75. Luckily for Your Everyday Joe, Zscaler popped to nearly $110 after the cloud-based cybersecurity company delivered blockbuster results for its fiscal third quarter. This resulted in a gain of 200% on the calls Your Everyday Joe had just purchased at the market open, prior to earnings. After his back-to-back earnings play wins, users on Wall Street Bets were curious of what his next move would be. It turns out Your Everyday Joe doesn't actually like gambling on earnings plays and is currently holding MongoDB Inc. and Elastic NV calls, which he plans to sell prior to their earnings reports. Congrats on your BJ's and Zscaler tendies, Your Everyday Joe! Next up, we have the user WSB Savant, posting a Robinhood screenshot showing that he lost $17,338, his entire account value. WSB Savant continued to lose money with next day's buy puts, going all in all the time. Eventually, his account was down to only $3, and he decided to withdraw to buy a used inflatable girlfriend. He's currently $40,000 in debt with student loans, but at least he isn't in Robinhood debt. Best of luck if you ever return to trading, WSB Savant. Last up, we have Torrential Tacos, posting a screenshot showing that he's up $32,710 on his Dollar Tree calls. On May 18th and 20th, prior to Dollar Tree's earnings reports, Torrential Tacos purchased 22 call contracts, expiring June 12th, with the strike price of $79.50 and $78. Luckily for Torrential Tacos, Dollar Tree posted better-than-expected earnings results, and the stock popped to nearly $100 on May 28th. He was able to secure his tendies after selling at around 10 a.m. that day. He decided to make this impressive play based off of Wall Street Bets, due diligence posts from these users, and it definitely paid off huge. Congrats on your Dollar Tree gains, Torrential Tacos! Thanks for watching this Wall Street Bets recap video. Leave a comment of what you're trading this week, and remember to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell. Be sure to check out our Wall Street Bets playlist for more videos like this. Best of luck getting those sweet, sweet tendies.